Hi guys, it's Kim Darwaza here, your Northern Virginia real estate expert. And tonight I want to talk to you about tax reform and how that is affecting real estate. I know a lot of people, I was going on listing appointments prior to the end of the year before these decisions were made, and people were kind of freaking out a little bit, like, how is this going to affect my sale of my home in 2018. So it really kind of came up. NAR, we did our job, our political action committee, we all really voted on this and really went to our legislators and said, we're not happy about this and it's going to really affect the real estate market. So really, but a lot was made to do about nothing that really came about it. There's really only one or two small things that were passed that really could affect people, but none of them are like crazy. So number one is the first thing was that you were going to have to live in your house 5 of the past 8 years instead of what was current 2 of the past 5 years to get the mortgage interest deduction. So that did not get passed. So it's still 2 of the past 5 years. And I think a lot of people think that because all these things were proposed that they were passed into law, but they were not. So we are still at the 2 of the past 5 years, so we're all good on that. And I've taken so many notes just because there was a lot of different parts in this. If I look down, I'm just kind of trying to refresh my memory because there's just a whole lot to talk about here. So the second, so that was like the 2 of the last 5 years, you have to live in your house in order to not be taxed on the profit. The second thing is the mortgage interest deduction. The Senate wanted to keep it at $1 million, which is currently what it's at, and the House wanted to bring it down to $500,000. So they kind of met in the middle, and the mortgage interest deduction is $750,000. Now, I think a lot of you are thinking, and if you have your loan prior to December 14, 2017, you're grandfathered, so it doesn't really matter. So I think a lot of people are like, oh my God, who has a mortgage that's $750,000? Well, in our Northern Virginia market, if you have a house that's $900,000 to $1.25 million, you probably fall in that bucket. And in Northern Virginia, there are a lot of people with mortgages that high because of our income levels and so on and so forth. So, and also the rule before was that you could spread it across 2 houses. So let's say your primary residence was $500,000 and then you had a beach house or a ski house and that was $500,000, that was combined. It wasn't just on your primary residence. So they were talking about taking that away and only saying it was for your primary residence, and that didn't get passed either. So the amount of people that it's really gonna affect with a $750,000 to the $900,000, you know, it's not really that many in the grand scheme of things. And a lot of people are like, oh my gosh, and then is our houses going to be slower and that? Well, honestly, a person who really wants a house and is in that price range is going to pay $300 more a month for the house they want and the house they love. They're not going to, I mean, $300 a month to them is not a big deal. So in our market, yeah, it would be like a $900,000 to $1.25 million house based on how much you put down. And honestly, for a while, the jumbo rates were much better than the rates on conventional financing. So I don't know. I don't know if it's still the same way. I mean, I need to defer to my loan officer, Christine Yerko. She's the one who keeps up with all the current stuff on the rates. So I would defer to her. She's with RMS Mortgage, and I can get you her information if you're interested. And again, if you purchased your home prior to December 15th, which I've owned my home since 1999, it does not affect me. I mean, my mortgage isn't that high anyway, but anyways. So also, people in this category, they made some changes to the alternative minimum tax or AMT tax, and those changes that they made in favor would kind of cancel out or make it a wash with your house deductions. So again, we don't think it's really going to affect the real estate market. So anyways, the next thing is you'll make it back in appreciation too over time. I mean, let's not forget about that. So one of the bigger ones is SALT tax, the state and local tax deduction you can take currently on your state and local taxes, which includes your property taxes. This affects people who live in higher tax states, for instance, New York, where they want to, you know, they get older and they have the taxes, or they need to move out of the island, off the island of Manhattan or Long Island, and move to Florida, which is a lot more tax friendly. So they all move down to Boca, which is what we call Manhattan South at this point, Boca or Palm Beach. So a lot of them will do that. Some people won't. It's, you know, they're going to move anyway sometimes when they retire. 70% of the country prior to this did not itemize deductions anyway. So they gave a larger standard deduction. So many people think now even 80% of Americans will not itemize deductions now that there's these new taxes. So people making up to $200,000 a year, it is probably not going to have a large impact on them. People who make $200,000 to $500,000, you know, it'll have more effect on them, but I don't think it's anything like earth shattering, to be honest with you. And honestly, if these people do move because of state and local taxes, you know, and the increases, people are like, oh my gosh, people are all going to sell their houses. And well, actually, it's going to free up inventory that we've needed for years. I mean, we are facing a inventory shortage here. And the places where this is mainly going to affect the higher cost markets, like New York, you know, the states with the highest taxes are like New York and California and places like that. Not our taxes here in Virginia are not that high, so we don't have to worry about it. So they do this report every year, and they have hundreds of industry experts, and they said that prior to these tax changes, that the prices were going to go up about of homes were going to appreciate about 4.5% in 2018, and about 3.5% in 2019. Now they're saying because of these tax changes, we may only see a 4% increase over the next 2 years, which is still pretty good instead of the 8%. And I just am going to defer to Mark Zandi. You can Google him. He's at Moody's Analytics. Mark Zandi, Z-A-N-D-Y, and Bill McBride. So he's from Calculated Risk. One of them is from the New England area, the Northeast, and the other one's from California. So it's good to look at both because you get kind of both. That one has more of a California opinion, one has more of an East Coast opinion, and you just kind of formulate your own based on their things. You know, I have a degree in finance, even though I'm a real estate agent from Virginia Tech, and I've taken enough classes to take the CPA exam. I've taken all the accounting. You can't like have a double major at Virginia Tech. So I took all the accounting classes to take the CPA exam, but I haven't been an accountant in a long time. So I'm going to have to defer to an accountant. So you definitely want to follow up with your accountant to see how this affects you. Cause again, I'm not a CPA. So anyways, and you can just Google Bill McBride and Mark Zandi and see and read their viewpoints. It's pretty interesting. And still 80% of Americans believe owning a home is part of the American dream. And that is not going to change. For the vast majority of Americans, home ownership is much more important to them than a tax break. I mean, let's be serious. I mean, you're not going to be like, well, I'm going to rent because my tax break isn't, you know, because I want to move every time someone wants to sell the house and have to move out and I can't paint my walls the color. I mean, yeah, that's just not going to, I mean, honestly, it's not going to happen. I mean, I have never in my 14 years in real estate ever heard one had a client say, I can't buy this because of the mortgage interest deduction. I mean, honestly, no one even knows what it is half the time, and I have to explain it to them as a benefit of buying a home. I'm like, oh, you're going to get the mortgage interest deduction. So even though you're paying this in your mortgage, you're going to get some of it back on your taxes. And I mean, people are thrilled by it. They just don't even know it exists half the time, first-time buyers. So at the end of the day, we don't have enough inventory right now for this to be a huge problem if people start selling. And honestly, again, we don't live in a higher tax state, so it's not really going to affect us. So for additional information, you can also go to the National Association of Realtors site, which is nar.realtor, to get more information. But all the, I went ahead and read multiple guides, and those are my biggest takeaways. So my biggest takeaways is it's really not gonna affect the general public. So don't be worried about it. And obviously, if you have additional questions, I'm more than happy to answer them. And if I can't, I'm more than happy to get you in touch with the appropriate people. I have a Rolodex full of accountants, attorneys, loan officers. So thanks for watching. And if you have any questions, 703-856-2254. Again, that's 703-856-2254. And thanks for watching and have a great evening.